This one, my first wife and I, we were pen pals when I was in high school. And then when I went to college, we kept writing. I was from Ohio, and she was from here. Finally, she was at U of I and said, "Why don't you come over during spring break?" So I first set eyes on her on April 3rd, 1964. And I hung around that weekend a bit, took her back to college because it was a college weekend. We ran all over the countryside, kind of learning to like one another a lot. And 2 weeks, I went back to Ohio, but 2 weeks later, I came back on April 19th, we ran off and got married. So you might see the seeds for a problem marriage when we took off so quick. But this is called Shade State Park. When I took her back to U of I, we just stayed in our car for like 3 or 4 days, and we drove into Indiana, and there's a state park there called Shade State Park. And this talks a little about what went on there. The dark, cool countryside, black but with the ice crisp gnarly, is kept at bay by thin panes, moist, moist with steam heat from their parts, locked mouth to mouth, growing shut close together in dim light glow of 12-volt Chevy panel light, where thigh squeaks up, plastic starlight pattern, finger hut cover, front seat, forcing hard bends but ill-directed, almost man-thing toward the doily embossed, most impregnable, silky smooth panty cloth from her mom's spring catalog, J.C. Penney, 3 pair, $3.95. A forward assault is launched from the soft plastic armrest of an anxious thigh as wheel deflected. Knee and throbbing support arm is shifted slowly, wristband still awkwardly and painfully lifting moist air from sweet time's door-scented neck. Teeth bare, those once meant to bite and tearing blood antelope, but now nips instead, heated blood flushed fawn with growing passion. Still to devour, but somewhat more, sometimes less, controlled, more slowly cadenced, tongue-tasting, slippery, moist nape of right twisted neck. Blue ivory cameo in the dimming by hand radio light of young girl, pink flush hidden, but for the heat that even a young predator can sense. Her warm-scented breath rushes out, groin pushed, head twisted back, blue vein and neck muscles straining, fumbling hand now guiding young hand, young male hand, not now hesitantly to blood swollen arm, where fingers and hands slide under the lift damp silken membrane. Wet curls there, rushing for first time, after young hand. Now twisting and probing parts not known, before car part, along lone silver highway, threading across dark scented new fields, pregnant with life's rich new corn and soybean, pushing, pushing, pushing out through warm, moist spring earth. In fields, besides darkened valleys and mountains, with dark flowing river heading southward and northward, bending this way and that way, where fog rises for warm breath of most spent west jet stream. Steaming drown to caress her rich, snow-melted pondscape, nestled alongside Midwest's dark, full, fertile crescent, where long night's heart pleasure is driven now to cooling to essence, passing golden long streaming across creosote-laden rail time, edge of chalk, white light parking lot. Crushed gravel now betraying, tennis shoe shifting burden, youth sleepily dreaming in particulars to next step, after pause to eat nature's second fall during the night. Fine journey, never some was ever taken, cross mother nature's beckoning night plane. Can round softness feel so heavy in cupped hand, gently squeezing through the carpal, warm swelling? Young heart felt quickly pounding against back of hand from the crest up tight to warm and heaving bare rib cage, just north of moistened maple, where button skirt lies safe now, for the moment ever fleeting. Frontal assault being planned once, but now lost in the heat of the maneuver for closer surprise. A campaign like a small baby where mouth and tongue. can't say how I long for those moments. The love of my heart then is long left. Memories gone. Those treasured memories left, and now uncertain.